everyone. Welcome to another session of class 9 mathematics, and I am your Anu again for mathschool.1. Actually, we have been seeing chapter 2 polynomials, and we have finished all the problems, some problems related to zeros of the polynomial, and we have also found factors regarding remainder theorem and bifactor theorem too. And in the last class we have seen actual division and we have found the factors of the polynomial, isn't it? Now in this class we'll start with another topic called algebraic identities. And now we have been doing factorization, isn't it? So we have factorized the given polynomial in the previous class. We have seen factor theorem, how to use factor theorem to factorize, and by division too. Now we have some standard formulae, and they are called algebraic identities by which we can factorize also. Okay, so we'll see some of the standard formulae or some of the standard algebraic identities we use in algebra to solve problems, to simplify or to factorize. Okay, so let us see some of the algebraic identities today. Algebraic identities. Now, regarding this algebraic identities, I would like to say a fact, I would like to share a fact, that is, algebraic identities were originally developed for finding areas of shapes. When surveying land, people used they coined the usage of literals, that is A, B, C and so on, to find the area of the land. So to find area of the land, they found that using literals was so easy than to use the real numbers. That is, they used the generalized form of finding areas than using the actual numbers, so that they can substitute any value in those literals to find any kind of area, so that the measurements were easy for them. So they introduced this, that is, they developed this method of introducing literals, which forms the chapter, which forms a separate subject called algebra. Okay, so that is what we are going to do now. Actually, this will be a very important thing in the algebra, because we will use all these identities and formulae as and when we move on to next chapters, and in higher classes too we'll be using these identities for simplification. So it is better if you remember all these identities by heart, okay, so that you will be able to use it wherever possible and the simplification will be easy for you. So we have two types of identities, that is, one is square identity and another one is cubic identity. Okay, so under these two headings we'll be seeing algebraic identities. Now, what are square identities and cubic identities? Actually, you have been studying this, or you have read this in the later, in the last class, previous classes too, in 8th, and you would have started algebra and as early as 6 itself, and the identity regarding identities you would have read in 8th class too. So now let us recollect it. The square identities are a plus b the whole squared is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. Okay, so how did this come into use? I said they used to measure land, isn't it? So this is A and this is also A, so this forms a square. Okay, and regarding this, this is A, so this is a rectangle where the length is A and the breadth is B, and here you see this is A, this is B, so this is again a rectangle and this is a square. Okay, so now how did they find this? They have split the total area into A and B. They have given literal forms to the measurements, and the square area is A squared here, and this is AB, and this is AB again, length into breadth is area of a rectangle, you know, and this is b square. So when adding all these things, you get a square plus b square plus 2ab. That is what? A plus b the whole square. See, a plus b, a plus b, a plus b, a plus b. This is a square, and the square has been split into a and b as squares and rectangles. If you add all the areas individually, you will be getting the term for a plus b the whole square. So that is how they developed the method of using algebraic identities in their calculations. So that is how it goes. So likewise, a minus b the whole square will be a square minus 2ab plus b square. This can also be done as a plus b into a plus b, which is nothing but a plus b the whole square, isn't it? So a into a is a square, a into b plus b into a anyway is 2ab plus b into b is b square. So likewise, a minus b into a minus b will give you a square minus 2ab plus b square. And next is a plus b into a minus b. So what is a plus b into a minus b? It is a squared minus b squared. Because see, when a plus b is multiplied with a minus b, we have a into a squared, a into b minus b, that is minus ab, plus ab minus b squared. So ab plus ab gets cancelled and you get a squared minus b squared. Okay, so this is one of the identity. And the next one is x plus a plus into x plus b. That is, x is the same, whereas a and b are some numbers. So you have x squared plus x into a plus b. Why x into a plus b? Because see, x into b plus x into a. So x is common, a plus b plus ab. So this is some of the formulas you have in square identities. And from these square identities, we will be able to derive the intermediate results from these. That is, a squared plus b squared. What is a squared plus b squared? It is a square. What is a squared plus b squared? It is a plus b the whole square minus 2ab. So we write a plus b the whole square minus 2ab. Okay, the results from the identities. Next, and a squared plus b squared is also found in this formula. So that is also equal to a minus b squared plus 2ab. See, here it is minus 2ab. When plus 2ab comes to this side, it becomes minus 2ab. And when minus 2ab comes to this side, it becomes plus 2ab. But anyway, you will get the result as a squared plus b squared. So these are some of the intermediate results from the identities. And these are the square identities, but these square identities are with two variables, a and b. So we extend these square identities for three variables too, a, b and c. Okay, so when we write square identity for three variable, it becomes a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ac. So they understand. So it is a squared plus b squared plus c squared plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ac. So this is one of the identity where you use three variables. Okay. So these are some of the square identities. And now we will move on to the cubic identity. What are all the cubic identities? We have seen square, a plus b the whole square will give you a square plus b square plus 2ab, and we have seen a lot of square identities. Now it is cubic identity. A plus b the whole cube is, see, a plus b the whole cube is, you just substitute a plus b the whole squared into a plus b. You just expand it as a plus b the whole squared into a plus b. A plus b the whole squared, you know, a squared plus 2ab plus b squared, that multiplied into a plus b, you will get a cube plus b cube plus 3a squared b plus 3ab squared. This can also be rewritten as a cube plus b cube plus 3ab. I take it as common. See, ab 3 common. So inside I have 3ab. AB into A plus B. So this is, these are two ways of writing A plus B the whole cube. Now what is A minus B the whole cube? Here it is, here both the terms are in positive, So you get all positive terms. Now you have minus b here. So accordingly, you should write minus b cube. Now b is minus here. So minus 3a squared b. Now b squared. So plus 3ab squared. And this can also be written as a cube minus b cube minus 3ab into a minus b. So just remember, see how we write, how we rewrite this. So there are two ways, two methods of writing. A plus b the whole cube and a minus b the whole cube, and these two can be applied in formulas. And very well, you will be asked to find a plus b and a minus b. You will be given with a plus b and a minus b, and you need to find the values of the other things. So you can use the second way of writing the cubic identities too. Now after doing this, another one is a cube, that is a plus a cube plus b cube, that is, see, a cube plus b cube is there in the a plus b the whole cube identity, but we have another form of writing a cube plus b cube. That is, if I have a cube plus b cube, just write a plus b and put the opposite sign in the middle. See, you have minus sign here, but write a squared minus ab plus b squared. It is not 2ab, a squared minus just ab plus b squared. And for a cube minus b cube, you carry over the same sign as here. See, if it is plus, you write plus here. If it is minus, you write minus here. And put the opposite sign here. Okay. So this is what a cube plus b cube and a cube minus b cube. So cubic identity, some of the cubic identities. And the next cubic identity in the line is you have a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc as a plus b plus c into a squared plus b squared plus c squared minus ab minus ac minus bc. So this is one of the cubic identity you have, where you have three variables here. So a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc is equal to a plus b plus c, a squared plus b squared plus c squared minus ab minus ac minus bc. Okay, so this is one of the formula. Now in this, if we have a condition here, if a plus b plus c is equal to 0. If in some problems, if you have the sum of the variables, see, a cube plus b cube plus c cube is given, isn't it? You have the individual sum a plus b plus c. If it is 0, see, if it is 0, the whole term becomes 0 here in the RHS, isn't it? So therefore, a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc is equal to 0, or a cube plus b cube plus c cube is equal to 3abc. So this is a condition when a plus b plus c is equal to 0. So that you should keep in mind. You will be applying this when you see the sum of three variables is 0, then we can apply this formula. Okay, so these are some of the square identities and cubic identities you have. And the last one you have is, see, the same a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc can also be written as half of a plus b plus c into a minus b the whole square plus b minus c the whole square plus c minus a the whole square. Okay, so this can also be written as a plus b plus c the whole cube minus 3abc. Earlier we saw it is a plus b plus c into a squared plus b squared plus c squared minus ab minus bc minus ac, isn't it? So that can also be written as half into a plus b plus c into a minus b the whole squared b minus c the plus b minus c the whole squared plus c minus a the whole squared. So these are some of the identities you need to remember, and this will be useful for you to factorize or to simplify problems related to the algebraic identities. So you have many types of factorization which involves the square identities as well as the cubic identities, and you need to get the intermediate results too, which I have given you the intermediate results from the identities what we have studied. So you have to remember all those things, and you have types of factorization which uses all these types of identities, and we'll be seeing the problems and exercises in the coming classes. So we'll be able to factorize or simplify using these algebraic identities. So till then, please do remember these, go through these algebraic identities and remember them, so that while we solve the problems, you'll be able to recollect the algebraic identities. Okay, so that's it for this class, and in the next class we'll be doing problems on algebraic identities. Until then, it's goodbye from Anu for mathschool.1. Thank you.